on the same floor and never met before until I'm overseas on tour. And peep this Ethiopian queen from Philly taking classes abroad. She's studying film and photo flash focus record. Says she working on a flick and cut my click through the score. She says she loved my show in Paris at Elise Momar, and that I stepped off the stage and took a piece of her heart. We knew from the start that things fall apart, intent to shatter. She like, no matter when I get home, get at her through letter phone. Whatever, let's link, let's get together. You think not? Think the throw her home, I forgot. Time passed, we back in Philly, now she up in my spot. Telling me the things I'm telling her is making her hot. Started building with her constantly round the clock. Now she in my world like hip hop. And keep telling her, telling her, yeah.
Good, Folkers. Snap Turtle in the car on his way to work. We'll be honking, man. Anyway, what's good, y'all? It's Monday, June 15th, 2019. You know, overcast morning. Had a little sprinkles going on this morning. Yeah, a bit overcast. But what's good, y'all? Today, I wanted to talk about something. Very, very interesting, okay? Talk about something very interesting. I want to talk about triggering hypocrisy, okay? Triggering hypocrisy. And it's very crucial that you're able to see what I'm talking about. I'm going to explain what I'm talking about, and I want you guys to start seeing what's going on in the world around you and who you're dealing with and the people that you follow. These so-called leaders that are trying to make change and do that in the third, right? So, hold on. So, What I mean by triggering hypocrisy, what I'm talking about is that you have these certain individuals, right? And it's always this particular group that I'm referring to, okay? Now, there are certain groups like these red pill takers, right? That talk about how some black people are easily triggered, right? Easily triggered. Yet, the things that trigger them have you going, wait a minute, what the hell? Like, you're always talking about people being triggered and operating in emotion, but when this happens, you're triggered, and so you want to create this drastic, you know, these drastic measures, these drastic consequences for this particular action. Now, I'm going to talk about a specific action that triggers the red pill people. Now, I'm not just red pill people, but anybody that call themselves being on the right? The right wingers, okay? Now, I don't know if you guys heard, but Trump, a couple years ago, was all up in arms about flag burning. Okay, flag burning. And he felt like there should be consequences like jail time and maybe losing your citizenship if you're caught burning a flag. Okay? And now, there's this person, a senator, trying to start an amendment, an actual amendment, not just a law, but an amendment to the Constitution that would prosecute anyone who burns a flag. Now, my question would be, why are you so triggered by flag burning? What is driving you to want to create these laws? Is it emotion? Is it emotion tied to a false patriotism that really honors symbols over people? Let me get into that. Candace Owens, she said, no, I don't want you to get jail time or anything like that. I don't want you to get fined for burning the flag. You should get exiled if you call burning the flag. Your citizenship should be snatched from you, and you have 1 year to leave the country, and you got to be bye-bye. Now, this is from a woman who says that black people shouldn't be triggered by perceived racism, okay? There are a number of individuals out there, like Candace Owens, who have taken the red pill and feel like acts like burning a flag should be prosecuted. But there's a reason that flag burning is not in the Constitution, because it's not important. Now, burning a flag may be a little pointless, but it may trigger people. It may cause, like, even a veteran, right? Some people feel like if you burn a flag, you're disrespecting the veterans. Well, I'll tell you, as a veteran myself of the United States Army infantry, you know what I'm saying? I'm not triggered by people burning the flag. As a matter of fact, I served my country, and any veteran should feel this way. If you served your country, right? You served your country, you should have no problem with people exercising their First Amendment rights, because that's essentially what we're doing here. When you burn the flag, they're exercising their First Amendment rights. And that's what it's all about. And the Bill of Rights wasn't, I mean, it's not a set of rights that were given to us by the central government. No, these are rights that are natural born rights that we possess, that are in the Constitution so that they're expressly protected, all right? And flag burning happens to be one of those rights. But people on the right are so triggered by flag burning. Whenever they speak of other people being irrational about things that trigger them, it's like, what are you talking about? Go on about you. I mean, come on. Think about that. Think about that. What? So you burn a piece of cotton or whatever the hell is made from. It's just, I mean, come on. You know, there are hundreds of symbols in this world that people cling to and idolize, and it's getting absolutely ridiculous. You're calling for the exile of people who are exercising their First Amendment rights. But when Gucci makes a blackface sweater and black people get mad about it, you're telling them that they're being soft and victims and weak. Where they do that at? How is it that you're okay with Gucci making a sweater, a blackface sweater, or whatever, Gabba Gabooba shoes, Chimichacha shoes, whatever they call them, with the blackface on the shoe, the Bugallis or whatever the hell they call them? If black people get mad at a blackface sweater, you all up in arms. Oh, you so triggered. You so emotional. Get out your emotions. Oh, stop being a victim. Don't let that bother you. Well, the same could be said about flag burning. Why are you so triggered by flag burning? And see, this is the type of shit I be talking about with these red pillars, these right wingers, who always shit on the left. The leftist elites for pandering to black people, right? You get mad at, you know what I'm saying? You point out the pandering, and yes, it's absolutely true. The left panders to black people. The left panders to illegal immigrants. The left panders to homosexuals. The left panders to this, that, and the third. So, what you want to do, you want to bring black people over to your side with some more elites, right-wing elites, right? But you want to do it by telling us, oh, stop being victims and doing... No, it don't work like that. So are you a victim when they burn the flag? What was it? Are you a victim when the flag is burned? Hell no. Neither is a veteran. Y'all were mad. Y'all were so mad at Kaepernick for kneeling. Now, first of all, let me talk about that. I ain't kneeling for no motherfucking body. I don't kneel, okay? I'm a wildling, okay? I'm a wildling in the north, okay? North of the wall. I'm north of the wall. I'm a wildling. I don't kneel to nobody. So I felt like that was kind of a weak move. I understand that he did that because a Navy SEAL or whatever the fuck, a Green Beret, talked to him about it. Like, so what? See, y'all were so mad at Kaepernick for being triggered by police brutality and the overwhelming disparity in you know what I mean? Like police brutality and police targeting black people. Why are you so triggered? Why would you be so upset by someone being triggered by police brutality? But you're triggered. You don't want people to be triggered, but you're triggered by a man kneeling during a national anthem. They're kneeling. They're not doing anything to anyone. It's a silent protest. They're not harming anybody. They're not stopping anybody's money. They're protesting. They're kneeling. So what? If he sat, I'd have sat my ass down, right? I'd have laid down or something. I'd have, taken a nap during the fucking match. Fuck that. Stand on your nuts. If you're going to protest, if you're going to do that, don't kneel. Kneeling is a position of weakness. Kneeling is a position of submission. It's a submissive position. I'm not kneeling for no fucking body. Anyway, I digress. You're upset. You're triggered by our being triggered by police brutality. Where they do that at? huh? To the point where Trump wants to wants people to be fired for kneeling during the anthem or not doing what, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't have to kneel. I don't have to stand. I don't have to stand for the national anthem. I don't have to recite the national anthem. It's my fucking God-given right. But you want me to be fired and exiled. Is burning a flag that harmful? You know, if I have any veterans following me, y'all let me know in the comment section if you're triggered by a flag burning. I'm not. Because for what? For what? I'm not going to call for the exile of a human being. Oh, you got to leave this country because you burned a piece of fabric. Hell no. It makes no sense. And this is my problem with people on the right. The sheer hypocrisy they possess in regards to what they decide to be offended about and being offended by other people's offense. How are you offended by someone else being offended by something because you don't understand it? Either you are for the expression, free expression and free thought and free speech, or you're against it. Freedom of expression, freedom of speech. The First Amendment is not just about freedom of speech. It's about freedom of expression. It's about the freedom to, gather, the freedom to practice a religion, whatever it may be. It's the freedom of expression. And burning a flag is expression. That's exactly what it is. It's an expression. It's not an expression you like, but oh well, get over it. If you go to somebody's page and they're burning a flag, you don't have to watch their page. Just like you would tell somebody, you know, that is seeing something they consider hate speech. Somebody on YouTube is calling people the N-word, or they're dressing in burkas and talking shit about a specific religious sect. They don't have to watch them, right? Because that person who's doing the offensive bullshit has the right to do it. They have the right. And so, instead of telling people, if you don't feel like the burning a flag is a right, then you're a treasonous. You're a traitor. Whenever you go against another human being's rights, anywhere you are, anytime you violate somebody's rights, anytime you administer force on people for not doing what you want them to do, by not following your edicts or agreeing with your opinion, then you're a traitor to humanity, not just the United States. You have no right to tell people where they can and can't go because they burned something. You have no right. How dare you? How dare you sit up here and act like it's the worst thing in the world? How dare you sit up here and think and act like it's horrible? It's a horrible thing to be triggered by racist text messages between police officers and a police department, but sit up here and fucking get mad when people burn a flag. It makes no sense. Like, this is the bullshit I'm talking about. This is what the right-left paradigm creates. It creates this bullshit that's completely unnecessary, is out of pocket, and it's a waste of energy. And for somebody to have to sit up here and talk to you guys as though you're children and trying to explain to you what hypocrisy is and how you're being a hypocrite, you know, I mean, come on, we had bigger things to worry about. You know, and then, shit, I mean, come on, man. I shouldn't be triggered, right, by a person, like a group of white ladies, holding up a small noose in a picture. I shouldn't be triggered by that, right? If I were triggered by that, and I called for the firing of those white women who decided to hold up a noose in a picture at their school that they worked at, where they're teaching children, where they're around children all day, impressionable young minds, molding and shaping people as they're growing. You know, these people are raising your children, and they're holding up nooses in the picture, right? And never mind the context. I shouldn't be triggered by that. But you can be triggered by burning of a flag. Or people shouldn't be triggered by a dummy that looks like Obama hanging from a noose on a tree in the South. We shouldn't be triggered by that. We shouldn't want those people to be arrested or anything like that, right? We shouldn't. They have the right. They have the right to hang dummies from a tree. That's their right. We don't have to like it. And we can even let these people know, like, look, man, this shit is mad disrespectful. It's racist, blah, blah, blah. But if they decide to still keep that thing up, that's on them. That's what they want to do. So guess what? It's on their property. It's hanging from their tree. It is what it is. As long as they don't put their hands on you and try to hang your ass, you can be upset all you want. You have a right. And it's understandable to want that person to have to pay for that type of expression. But at the end of the day, it left no victim. At the end of the day, you have to put on your big boy drawers, your big girl panties, and say, look, I'm just going to do what I do. If you touch me, as long as you don't touch me, you good. Well, guess what? The same thing should go for flag burning. You don't want people to be triggered by hanging dummies? Don't be triggered by burning flags. Hypocrisy gets no one anywhere. And that's all I got to say about all that. Anyway, hit that like button. Share this video, subscribe, whatever. But yeah, stop being hypocrites. You know what I'm saying? Take your red pill and be completely rational. If you want to call yourself logical and rational, you know, you can't pick and choose when to do that and still appear to be credible. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, that's all I got for now. Peace out.